Hello friends, hope you're doing well. My name is Dr. Milind Chinde, MD Pediatric from AIIMS Bhopal. So we have already talked about a lot of techniques and tricks in my channel videos and which can help you definitely in your preparation. But today what I'm going to talk about is how I improved on my mistakes and during my journey, how I worked on those areas which were troubling me. It's, as I said, that PG journey is not easy. There are a lot of problems that you're going to face, and it was not easy for me either. So when I started my internship, it was a time I was not very serious about PG preparation that time. I just wanted to enjoy the internship, wanted to get the practical knowledge, and it was fun time. So that was the time I met my initial people who inspired me. These were my residents, my seniors who inspired me. Okay. When I used to talk to them, they were like within rank 100, rank 500 in NEET that time. So I used to get inspired from them, but that time I was just reading these TAMS handwritten notes, and I did not do any classes that time. So but my dream was to be like them. These are the people who inspired me to write NEET PG and to prepare for the PG prep. You know, when I wrote my NEET PG during my internship, I got 27,000 rank, and that was also a reality check. That time I realized that talking with toppers is not going to fetch me a rank. I have to do the hard work. I have to make my plan. Just because I'm sitting with them, eating with them, that doesn't mean that I'm going to get the rank. So I just thought that, okay, let the internship get over and start preparing. So my target was next. And in this video, I'm going to tell you that what were the problems that I faced and how I overcame over those issues. So my first serious, like you say, like after preparation attempt was to go for November that year, because I started preparing in March, and my target was to go for November, because I had told to myself, I'm going to prepare seriously. I'm not going to take it lightly. So my source was still, as I said, that my DAMS notes. And as you, nowadays you get very good notes, like very good printing with a good handwriting. That time we used to buy that someone else had written, because as I told you that I had not done any regular coaching, I had done test and discussion. So that during that time, we used to get these notes that have very poor handwriting. So for a few subjects like anatomy, biochemistry, physio, as I told you that these are rank building and the most important subject. And also for something like ophthalmology. So for this, I had bought review books. For the rest of the subjects, which were rank maintaining subject, our big four, I was solely dependent on the notes. I had also one review book, I remember, for psychiatry and for forensic medicine, for which I felt that notes were not enough. And then for remaining short subject, I had my notes, the DAMS notes, which I had bought. So I decided that I'm going to just stick with this pattern I'm going to read. This was the year where I did the random MCQs, that I was not into so much of MCQs, because I used to feel that I have just to work on my, I have to just work on my, these areas. I have to just work on notes, and I have to read notes again and again. That was my plan. So these were the subject I concentrated upon, the basic first year subject. And I had them, like, my main focus was this subject, followed by short subject, and rank maintaining subject was my, like, least, I mean, I used to spend least time on those. So I prepared till November, and I wrote my, this NEET. So my rank in NEET this year was 6,500. And rank in my, and AIIMS was my, like, these were my two targets. That AIIMS was my main target, and NEET was my backup. In AIIMS, I got around 2,500. So I was happy, because 2,500 is, I felt, okay, I'm within 3,000. My dream launch was either medicine or pediatrics. Now you'll say that, sir, your rank is very good from 27,000 with your 1 year preparation. You got a very good rank at 6,500 is good rank. But see, guys, if you don't get your dream branch at this rank, this rank is as bad as 65,000 or 6 lakh. As I was not getting medicine or pediatrics at that rank or your category that year. So this rank did not mean anything to me. This was not giving me what I want. So I decided, okay, I'm going to go for AIIMS, because I feel that I'm very close to AIIMS. I mean, 2500 rank is very, I feel that I can do it. I can get a best rank in AIIMS. So what I did that you guys will ask me that, I thought that my preparation was on the point. When I wrote my NEET PG exam, trust me guys, I felt I was very happy. I felt that I'm going to be in top, maybe like 500. Because that was relatively very easy paper. And I thought that it was, I was very happy after a paper. But when we start, you know, analyzing, when I just was checking answers in between, I realized I had made 25 to 30 silly mistakes that year. not one or two, but 25 to 30, literally silly mistakes. I mean, I remember one question about the Malampati score. So there was an image given about a Malampati score, and they asked that which grade. And I said, it's two. I remember it was, I think it was three, but I had written two. And I was very confident it was two. And I was telling my friend also, Nini, it was two. And when I saw the image, and then I could not believe myself. I think this must have happened with you also. Like, you wonder, how can you make such mistake? Like, you have seen this point for so many times. You think that you're, what happened to your brain? And then there were multiple such things that I saw that I did blunders. And I think that was the reason I could not end up in both the exams. I could not end up in the top ranks. Also, what I did mistake during this period, that I solved very less MCQs. I literally solved like random MCQs. And I think that is what the lack of MCQ practice did not help me to get into that cream rank. But I just want to tell you guys one very important time point. If you see my rank, it was still good, 6500. And the reason being the command on this subject. I had a command on rank building subject that I made maximum correct in this subject. But I'll tell you, my weakest subject during this period was microbiology or something. And the also the short subject, I just underestimated them. I just read superficially the notes. I did not revise them well. So I think that is the reason I could not end up in top 5,000, that I had very less command on short subject. I mean, I neglected a few of the short subject, and micro, which was a very important subject, which I neglected. And I think around 10, 12 mistakes I made in micro itself. So that is something, see, as I told you, if you neglect any important subject, it is going to harm you. Then I decided to go for MAIMS, which was session like AIMS happens twice a year. So my target was next May session AIMS. So I knew that for AIMS, I have to concentrate more on subject like weights and off. So again, I started with the same goal. And as I told you guys that during this period, I was not having any mentor. Like there was no one that I could, you know, look up to, and there was no one to tell me, okay, you have to do this, these are the particular things. So why I'm sharing with you all these things, because you know, when you have a mentor who will tell you what to do, you can do it earlier. As Chanakya said, that you don't have to learn from your mistakes. I mean, you don't have to do all the mistakes to learn from your mistakes. You have to learn from others' mistakes as well, because you don't have so much time that you will do all the mistakes and then you'll learn. So whatever mistakes I did, I'm sharing with you, so you don't do the same mistakes and spoil your rank. So as I told you that I had a good command on rank building subject and a good rank maintaining subject. So that's why all the exam I wrote, I ended up within 10,000 because of this subject. So that is what I'm telling again and again. Have a strong, I mean, these subjects should be strong. So as I knew that Pitts and Ophtha also has a good weightage in names. So for ophthalmology, I was reading notes. So I thought, okay, I should go for the review book also, because this is again an important subject for names. But review book was too much. I could not finish it. So what I said that, okay, I'll look for another notes, because one, two answers I was not able to find. So I went for Bhatia notes. Then I again went for one book is there, Across We Used to Read. I read that also. I was just searching ki maybe which source is enough. And then I took, there used to be one book about triple O, orthopedics, otorhinolaryngology, and orthopedics. So ophthalmology, ENT, and orthopedics. So these three books used to be there. So I was reading ophthalmology from this also. So for one subject, I had nearly five sources, and this actually caused a lot of confusion in my mind. I was not able to read anything from ophthalmology. This also actually caused problem in reading other notes, because I wasted so much time on this. So this was one of the biggest mistakes I did. And I was still doing the random MCQs. I did not do any PYQs during this period, because nobody told me that it is important. So I was just doing the random MCQs, random test series, and giving test. And I was also looking for the rank again in test. I was not working on my weak areas, but I was just doing random MCQs. So this is the mistake I did. For a few subjects, I thought that this is not in my notes. So instead of strengthening those areas, and instead of reading those notes again to work on my silly mistakes, like for microbiology, instead of reading the notes, even like to avoid silly mistakes in a better way, I bought another review book, because I thought that things are not enough. But all the questions were from notes only. But I went for review book, and again, that was too much. So what happened when I wrote my aims, my session, my rank was 929. Again, same things, the silly mistakes had affected my rank. Yes, my rank definitely improved, because I was reading the notes again. So it was registering in my mind. But guys, let me tell you one thing. I believe that if I had stuck to the notes, whatever I was reading in the previous session, I definitely would have got better rank in this session. But because I did this blunder, I did this mistake, and I did not solve PYQs, it harmed me. There were a lot of questions in AIIMS session which were like from last JIPMER or AIIMS questions, which I made wrong, and that affected my rank. Now this is the moment when I came in contact with few people, and this was the time I met my mentors. So when I was working as a non-ACAT JR in AIIMS, New Delhi, so I met few people who told me that what should be done. Whatever I'm sharing with you is the wisdom that was transferred to me, and I'm transferring to you guys. So what I did, what I improved, this was a time when I understood the importance of PYQs. And I made one strict rule that I'm going to make one subject, one book rule. I remember one line from, I used to read and see a lot of interviews that time. I remember a lot of students used to follow DAMS classes that time. So Dr. Sumesh Shetty sir had once said, if it is not in your books, so probably no one knows it. So that was the thing. Like most of the classes, they cover 99% of the portion. So if there is one question particularly that did not come from your notes, see, that means that most of the students in India, they don't know about it. So don't worry, because that is your competition. You don't have to cross certain score. You just have to beat others. So that is what about PG exam. The third point was I got introduced to the first aid USMLE book during this session. But someone, I read a lot of interviews. I saw a lot of interviews, and everybody, like I saw that AIIMS topic, because I said that my target was AIIMS. So I said, lot of AIIMS toppers, they talk about this book. They say that you just read it, somehow it helps. So I just decided that my primary source will be notes and review books for those. The notes, I was feeling okay there. The handwriting was not comprehensible for me. Plus PYQs, plus first aid. So this, I decided that will be my baseline thing. And I'm not going to do anything beyond that. Still there was one mistake I did. Because for image-based question, I was not understanding that what should I do. So one of my friend, he had attended some visual session by some classes, and he had the two students can access it. So I was just using his device, and one of what I realized, there were thousands of images, there were like 10,000 or more than that images were there. And when I was going through those images, I started feeling dizzy. I was not understanding anything. And I think that I wasted nearly 2-3 weeks on that, because I thought, okay, maybe that is more important, but they give you everything. They give you every image available in the textbook. So you're not going able to register that. But still, I could revise good. During that time, I revised well, and I used this formula. So that session, in it, I got rank around 2700. And in AIIMS, I got rank 457. So this was the time my fight with the PG exam ended. And I realized, if someone would have told me that do PVC and MCQs, just stick to your notes and revise them well. And, I'll tell you about the first edition later. But if someone would have told me this thing earlier, I would have done it. I would have, because I remember that now, this caused me less confusion, and I answered my question paper better. It was similar what I had written in the last year. It was same kind of difficulty level. But because I did so many blunders in the preparation period, that's what helped me. So guys, that's what I want to tell you, that if you want to get a good rank in NEET, PG, this is what you are going to need. Now, as I said, that my battle with the PG exam was over. I was getting MD medicine seat that time, and also like pediatrics, which was my top two choices. But guys, there was some attraction about AIIMS. That thing about AIIMS was still lingering in mind. And this rank actually forced me to prepare for AIIMS again. This rank was like, I knew that I'm very close. Now I'm in top 500. And I knew that one thing, that I just need another push to get into AIIMS. I told myself that what I will do. My friends called me crazy that you're leaving your dream branch. It's never about college. Yeah, they counsel me. But again, guys, as I told you, that it depends on how much are you willing to risk. If I would have taken my NEET seat, the college usually starts in April or May. And the next exam was again in May. So I thought I can still take a chance. I can still, take a chance for this May session exam. So, but, I was willing to take this risk. So I took, I decided that I'm going to go for AIIMS. So I left that counseling. I did not participate in counseling because my dream was bigger than any fear. I decided that, I did not think that this will be my last chance. I told myself this is going to be my best chance. This will be the best exam I'll write. This will be the best preparation I'll do. And I knew that I don't have to do anything extra. There is no magic. It just, you have to do the previous year MCQs. You just have to do, I mean, work on your notes. So what I did during this period, I decided that I'm going to prepare for May. I left the counseling. I was still reading the same notes, not any updated notes or anything, or review book, which the notes were not good, for which the notes were not good. The second thing were PYQs. In PYQs, what I did was Jipmer by T. Arun Babu. I solved last 5 years MCQs with very religiously, like with the focus and concentration, with explanation. I did not want to do any mistake. And you know, when I did this previous MCQs, now I found a lot of questions that were asked in November session. They were like from last 4 or 5 years of Jipmer. They were actually Jipmer questions, maybe a little bit twisted. And then I realized that, you know, why I was not able to get the rank, because the same question come, the topic, the question from the topic was coming. For AIMS, I saw there was Amit Ashish book of previous year MCQs of AIMS. That time Nitesh, this Pritesh Singh sir's books was not there. His surgery book was there only in the market, not previous year MCQs. Then Amit Ashish PYQs of last 8 years I did for AIMS along with the MCQs. See, there will be some topics will be outdated. Some things will be outdated and you will know it. So I was neglecting that, but I saw last 8 year MCQs. There are also PGI book by Dr. Manoj Chaudhary, but I did not read that because that was too much for me, because my main concentration was on AIMS. So I solved, and you know, guys, I realized that time solving Jipmer MCQs somehow helps in AIMS. And Jipmer also has a habit of introducing a lot of drugs. So you don't have to waste your time on drugs also. Third is for image-based questions, because I told you that, you know, the blunder I did last session by just going through a lot of images. Instead, what I did, that there were a few books. One was Langmann's Embryology. I had its PDF. Second was Nature's Atlas. Then Ganong's Physiology. Ganong's Physiology. Then Dr. Neena Khanna. Books of Dermatology. And Robin's Path. So I had PDF of these books. So what I did, I used to screenshot images from these books and I used to save them in my folder. So when, and what I used to do, I will not do it separately. When I am reading a particular topic, I will see this image. So it helps me retaining theory also, and to understand the image better and to retain image better. And that's what I advise. Even if you don't want to use this textbook, just search on Google image. Sometimes I was too lazy to open the textbook or go for the PDF because it is to take a lot of time. So I'll just open on a Google and I'll take a screenshot of all the images that were available in my screen and I will just save it. So whenever I'm revising it, I did that for the image based question. And the fourth thing here was what? First aid, USMLE first aid. My plan was to, because I read in every interview given by AIMS topper, they said that you have to read first aid, somehow it helps. Yes, I'm telling you guys, most of the questions from first aid, it's like a, because AIMS is basically on the basic sciences. So first aid helped me a lot for solving this basic sciences question. And my target was to finish it, at least read it 3 times before my exam to have a better knowledge. And I used to take a lot of photos from these charts and table from the first aid. So this was my preparation plan for mains, notes and review books, which I was reading. One subject, one book, previous year MCQs, Jipmer 5 years, AIMS last 8 years with explanation. I did not solve any subject wise MCQs. For first aid, I read it 3 times before my AIMS exam, so I could finish it. And I took images from the standard textbooks plus Robin's Path. And also I used, standard textbooks and Google. And I also used to see the instruments. If I'm reading some instrument, some spatula or some very like named forceps, I used to search it on Google also. So after this all, and as I said that this was my last battle. I mean, this was about my dream. This was about myself. This was about my pride, because I already had cracked NEET, but AIMS was still, I was not able to crack. So this May session in AIMS, I got rank 125. And for Jipmer, I got rank 165. And then that was the moment I realized, okay, now my battle with AIMS is over. And that time there were 5 other peripheral AIMS were also there. And at this rank, I was getting DM infectious diseases in AIMS New Delhi. I was getting MCS pediatric surgery also in AIMS New Delhi. So this was the like branches I was getting there. And also other branches like ENT and anesthesia, but as I told you that my branch of choice is medicine and pediatrics. So at this rank, thankfully I got MD pediatrics in AIMS Bhopal. And then I realized, okay, now I have to, you know, put down my all the, I mean, this, my battle is over. And now I knew that, okay, I'm done. I am not going to write any more exams. And I was happy. And you know, what I want to tell you guys from this all, in this video, once you start cracking one exam, everything will come. Like, I got the similar rank in JIPMER. So that's what I'm trying to tell you. It's all about the technique. Ask yourself why all the PG aspirants, they read the same material, but why only few succeed? The reason is about the technique and knowing the right thing. Sometimes I wonder if, you know, if I had met those people during my initial period, maybe I would have got into PG earlier. But you know, that's not happens. I mean, that's not the case all the time. But guys, now you have a lot of mentors. You are lucky that there are people who are there to tell you. There are people who are ready to help you. So work on those areas. Work on your mistakes. You don't have to go here and there. Just talking to toppers, just watching a lot of videos, or you know, going through a lot of books is not going to give you rank. What is going to give you rank is your hard work and how you plan your study. Through my video series, I am repeatedly telling how you should formulate your study, how should you plan your study, how to avoid on those areas. And do not forget about rank building, rank mentoring, and rank deciding subject, and how to give them the priority. And I think that having the command on rank building subject always faced me rank below 10,000 in NEET and below 1,000 in AIIMS. So guys, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Just work on those areas and this will definitely fetch you your dream branch. This was my journey, and this is how I overcame my mistake. And you know, every PG aspirant has an untold story, as I had and a lot of you are also having. So work hard until your struggle stories turn into success stories. So guys, I hope it helps. I wish you guys all the best. Take care.